Good morning. Good morning, yeah. Thank you. So we've been doing a lot of work in what I'll call as the generics of construction work. We talked about how tenders work. We talk about how we bid for a job, and then we've talked a little about how we get a job done. We've not talked much about equipment. We've not talked, I don't know whether we've talked about human resources. If you look at any job, any organization, human resources is the most valuable resource. Do you know why? Why do you think human resource is the most valuable resource? Do you agree that human resource is the most valuable? Yes. See, suppose you say that human resource is not valuable, all of our jobs are at stake. Nobody will get a job. Do you know why? I can make a computer learn all the knowledge. Look at the speed with which Google gives you results. It's able to understand what you're doing. It knows what you want or what your intent is. Okay. But then, change is not being brought by computers till now. If you look at most of the technologies, they have been introduced. We use computers to help us do it better. BIM, for instance, it's a technology. We use BIM, we use our knowledge, and then we improve or improvise on it. Another very what we'll call as a emerging topic is that Internet of Things. Everything communicates with the other. So in the US, many of the bridges have got some instrumentation put into it, which will tell the behavior of the bridge, or you can monitor the health of the bridge from a remote point of space. So if you look at it, computers are not telling you, please think of Internet of Things. You do the Internet of Things. But what computers are very good at, go to that bridge. That bridge is in distress. How did it do it? You fed the parameters stating that if this condition is met, you can say that a bridge is in distress. Okay. Again, learning is not exactly what you see in a textbook, right? Learning is going to require much more work from you. Earlier, this hard calculation was not, you know, like this calculation which you do, analysis and all that, had to be done manually. So all the engineers were trained to do things by rote. Like you have to do all the spellings, you have to do it in these steps. Follow the steps, you can do it. But the algorithm, once you give it to a computer, it's now able to do. But to generate algorithms, we are still required. Okay. So, with the understanding that human resource is very valuable, let us start our discussion for today. Okay. Industrial psychology is what we'll call as the, you know, human resource part of our study. Every industry is having people. And these people make up the DNA of the organization. What the organization stands for is going to be said by them. Okay. We, in one of the earlier lectures, we were talking about how change can be managed, right? A lot of the people had put that in their answer scripts. Change. Okay. I am very glad that it kind of stuck onto them. So today we are going to try to see some of the things in industrial psychology. Okay. Now, what happens is, if you look at an organization like Tata's, they talk about values. For them, value is more important, not the value of things, what they stand for, what they believe. There's a story which I read about Tata. I don't know whether it's true or not. So once one of our neighbors was very keen on importing Tata sumos, but then he refused. So the people went to the top ministers. They told, sir, look, this guy is not doing it. Please, for diplomacy or something like that, they did. So when the ministers spoke to him, it said that he told, you may have lost your shame, but I don't want to lose mine or something to that end. So that's what we call by values here. So for some organization, truth and honesty is paramount. Many of the organizations don't like to tell when data breach is there. So things like this. So if I'm in an organization which was hiding facts, and I go to an organization where, you know, the value systems are different, there's going to be a very big difficulty in the way we are going to work. Okay. Of late, you would have seen there are two or three very big shakeups in the corporate houses. Very big corporate houses brought in big names, thinking that they'll make their organization great, but it looks like their core values were affected. Okay. So one of the things which you need to understand is, if you are taking a person and then you're going to let him go, it's going to cause a lot of distress. Okay. Now, this is the basic premise on which I'm going to have this lecture today. So, we earlier saw that, you know, industry provides a means by which, you know, some collective work can be done. To do a very big construction work, individuals cannot do it. Individual machines cannot do it. So you need to have something that connects all of them, and that's what organization is all about. When there is a way by which people know where resource has to be applied, we find that it's used effectively. You want 10 cranes, 10 cranes are brought to site, but then on that day you find that the work for the crane is not available. So that's where, you know, organization comes into it. And the other thing is, how people behave, interact with each other is very important in the success of an organization. You may have the best of people, but if suppose they are not able to sit and see eye to eye, you're going to find that there's going to be a lot of difficulty. Okay, so that's where, you know, values, the way, you know, you're going to think, so many things come into the picture. Okay, so this is something which we actually saw earlier. I'm just repeating that. It is just that, you know, to overcome the individual's limitation, we need to have a collective system, something which will help you see how we can make the most of various resources. The other things, of course, we are social beings and we want our material needs satisfied. Okay. Now, this is the basic thing of what I'll call as the need for the HR department. Okay. Now, how many of you have had any experience with HR departments? Have you had any relationship with HR departments? Anybody's parents are in HR? Anybody's parents have talked about HR? Nobody. Right. So, how many of you own your business? Your parents own your business? Only 4, 5, 6. So, do you have a HR organization, HR part in it? MBA graduate or somebody? No. Okay, fine. So, one of the things which we see or talk about is that, you know, the HR department is there to make the people feel happy and comfortable to work with. So they want people to work with each other comfortably. They want a group of people who will work comfortably with each other. And they also want to ensure that they are all in an environment where productivity is very high. Okay, now if you look at when I was much younger, maybe, my God, it's 30 years ago. Okay, 30 years ago, if you go to a bank, it would be having long queues, even not 30 years. 2007, also it was 2005 also when I was first working, there's not much of this, there's no computerization. You still had to go to the bank, physically stand in a queue. And in the first college which I was working in, the punishment was like this. If you break a window, 50 paisa or something, like, you know, 2 rupees will be the cost of a test tube. They don't allow you to repay the test tube. They ask you to go to the bank, stand in line, pay for it. Okay. So now, main thing I'm trying to bring is that, you know, it was people intense at one point in time. A lot of people were required to do a work. Today, if you go to a bank, maybe, how do you like the experience of Indian Bank? The one which is nearby, quite good. How many of you have gone to a new generation bank, ICICI or something? Which do you prefer? ICICI. Why? Good service. Okay, see, that is because of the way they have used machines, basically speaking. Okay, so now, same banking, this one, same thing, put it in our construction site. You are going to build a similar building. Okay, now a technology empowered organization is going to have very few people who are going to be able to deliver. Now these people have to be the best. Okay, they need to work very comfortably with each other. And coming back to my case, at one point in time, people were bureaucratic. They were all sitting in offices. Hey, don't come to my desk, go to some other's desk. But now if you go to some offices, you'll find that people are working in groups. They'll be chatting, they'll be on Facebook, they'll be on other things. So many other things, but work is getting done. You'll find that they are friendly. You'll find that they are friendly. That if you go to this guy, he'll say, hey, yeah, come. Okay, so you want to talk? Why not? Yeah, just let's go to the coffee parlor. Maybe it's more comfortable. But in the old system, you go to the boss. Did you knock? Why did you knock? Not a room. Get out of my room. So that is the way they work. And then you want coffee? Okay, come, my dear, from the pantry, you'll call. Get me the coffee. This is the difference in the working styles today. Okay, now if I ask you to work in an organization, which type of organization do you like to work in? The more friendly one, where it is more, where you're finding it that, you know, you can listen to music at work, probably bring your pet dog. You know, some people say that they allow snakes in Google. Okay, pet snakes in Google. I don't know if you've heard of that. Okay, so now you see the work atmosphere has been changed to change the workforce. This is what I want to stress here. Maybe I meandered a little, but the point I want to make here is the workforce is having a changed environment. It's not anymore that glass door. You'll not find cabins in many of the places. Okay, now another thing here, there's another thing for the industrial organization psychology, where they see how they work as groups, how they work as individuals. Okay, now do you feel, how do you think a construction organization should work? Should it work as a group of individuals or a group of people? Isolated individuals, or is it a group of individuals? Today the workforce has changed. You have to be able to work as an individual. You have to be in a position to work as a group. It's changed. Today we don't have the luxury of having a boss and a boss above him to tell you how to do things. The day you go into the organization, you need to start working. I'll tell you one more interesting thing which happened yesterday. Finally I came to my office. So he told me, sir, so many things. So finally I wanted to ask him, I asked him one question. What was the intent 4 years ago when you entered VIT? Sir, I'll enter VIT when I go out, I'll build one structure. Okay. That is the essence of today's requirement. So when you go out, as an individual, you are going to be able to do the work. Nobody needs to supervise you. That much number of people there, reducing. So when you are getting a person for your organization, if you are starting your own business, you want him to do the work. You don't want him to come with you saying these are the problems. You want him to say, sir, I've solved so much, I've built for so much, profit is so high. Okay, so this is the other thing which I feel is very important here. So we make a scientific study of human behavior in the workplace. Now that is one of the biggest things in many of the MBAs. So they get graduates, the people like you, students like you, study how an organization works, where they are lacking, how to make it better. So this is the key to success today. Okay, now I'll take one example. 2 years ago, they made a study of people in Air India. So at that time, one of the airplanes was taken forcefully and crashed into a mountain. I think it was in Germany. Okay, so they wanted to evaluate their workforce, they wanted to see how good they were. So they did what they known as psychometric tests. So these are to evaluate how good the candidate is. So many of the things which you do is like give situations, so on and so forth. They can even see your Facebook profile, see your pattern of posting, and make an evaluation of the individual. Okay, so that's what they did. And they found that of the final list of people whom they shortlisted, only 30% passed the psychometric test. What does that mean? All your key skills, your engineering, that's great. Okay, your language skills, excellent. Your management skills, above ordinary. So these are skills. But then when you come to it, your the people to people skill was what is one of the things which they test. One of the things, okay, psychometric tests have a lot of things. One of the things they test is people to people skill. So there they failed. Okay. Now why do you need this? The moment I hire you for, or you hire me for instance. Okay, he is hiring me. He is paying me about 20% above the industry standard. He's paying me 20% above the industry standard. So I go to that organization. But then after 3 months, if I quit the organization, what happens? He's going to be in trouble. Do you know why? His boss is going to say, you spent so much of money getting a person, he's left. So typically what happens is, employee turnover is the time when an employee resigns and goes for better options or whatever. So very few people actually retire, but there's something called attrition. Attrition means when a person gets a better opportunity, they move on. Okay, how many of you will pass out an opportunity? For example, you're working in a very prestigious organization, maybe even L&T. You've been working 12 hours a day. Your growth rate has been good. But then somebody is offering 30% more salary. How many of you will still stick on to the old organization? Okay, so now what happens is, the organization will try to retain good employees, but then the so-so employees, they will allow them to go. Okay. See, for example, this year we've had 14 people taken by L&T. Of the 14, how many do you think will stay on in L&T for after 5 years? Put yourself in that shoe. Okay. So now, for an organization to hire a new person, train him or her and bring them to that level, it's very, very difficult. Okay, bring them to match the values of that organization is very, very difficult. Now, when the market is bad, you'll find that attrition will be very, very less. Okay, this pyramid, I'm not saying that it's the topmost priority. That is the amount of attrition that will happen. What is this? People voluntarily going out of the organization. People will not like to go voluntarily out of the organization, because if they go out, they don't have a chance of a job. Today I was looking at a forward. People are telling, now this is a very big controversy. Huh? If we say anything, we don't know what government is going to do. So I'm making a disclaimer that, okay, government, don't penalize me. 333,000 people are supposed to be jobless in Tamil Nadu today. Okay. Of which they are saying that 320,000 almost are graduates, trained or qualified, not trained, qualified people. They are having a degree, they are not able to find a job. Now at this point in time, how many of you will quit a job and go to another job? That is the thing where we are saying that, you know, attrition will be very low in a time when market is bad. On the other hand, when market is good, the other thing happens. It will be very difficult to retain a person in the organization, because always the grass is greener on the other side. Okay. So this is a very important thing. So why do you want to retain an employee? You want to retain him because you don't want to waste time training a new person. Okay. So what do you think is there which will do this employee engagement? What do you think will engage you? For example, what would engage you in a classroom like this class? I'm just asking you a general question. What would make you want to come to class? This is out of my curiosity also, guys, I want to know.
Interactive.
Okay, interactive, having an interactive session, okay. Then? Sorry?
Attendance.
Attendance. Okay. Free attendance or attendance when you're in the class? No, no, okay. Here I'm trying to see what will engage a person in a classroom.
Extra talks.
Huh?
Extra perks.
Extra?
Perks.
Extra perks, okay. Any other point? What will engage you in the classroom? Okay, what is engagement? I'll put it that, you know, make you productive in class. In your case, make sure that some kind of learning is happening. Okay, So, sorry? Right, I'll move on. See, engagement of employees is something which everybody will want. I want all of you to be bosses. Now, you want your employees to give much more than what you pay them. Am I right? So, suppose you are hiring a draftsman or a draftsperson. You may be paying them, say, 20,000 rupees per month. How much do you want them to produce output? For example, if each drawing costs 1,000 rupees, how many drawings do you expect from the draftsman? You're paying them 20,000 rupees. More than 30? So 30 drawings per month or one drawing per day. Okay, little more than one drawing per day. More than that, okay. Right, now look at it this way. A license of AutoCAD costs around, say, if it is $100 also, 6,000 rupees. Okay, so 6,000 rupees per month you are spending on AutoCAD. Electricity is 6 rupees per unit. Let us say that, you know, air conditioning, everything put together is costing you 6 rupees per day for that person. So 6 into 10, 60, 600, nearly 1,800 rupees is the investment on electricity. You bought a computer, you are paying, say, 3,000 rupees EMI on that. It's a very small amount for a workstation. Now you tell me how much you want to get out of that draftsman. How many drawings? See, now it makes 30 drawings make hand to mouth. Whatever you get, I'm giving back. But then, like, so I hope you get my point. You want them to do their work continuously. Every organization is blocking Facebook. Even VAT blocks Facebook on the official internet which they provide. No organization gives Facebook for the matter. Go to L&T, go to any other place, they will not allow. Naukri.com, this one, Money Central, so many are blocked because they feel that will divert attention. Okay. So, but what you want them to do, you want to engage them in the work. So, is forcing them going to help, or is there something else to make them work? That is the question which we need to answer so that your organization is thriving, so that the people in your organization decide to work. Okay. Now, so these are the things about the HR people. Okay. They are trained to ensure that the workplace is productive. They are trained to ensure that the workplace is productive. So these are some of the things which they do. They study human behavior at workplace. So are people doing this or doing that in the workplace? So what sort of behavior modification is required? What sort of behavior modification is required? How to increase productivity? Okay, so that is the main aim for these people. These are two websites of companies where I worked. I deliberately put it because I feel that, you know, they may not sue me. If you look at the website, they all promise a challenging career. Okay, you look at any website, including VIT's career webpage, you'll find that all the companies try to give a very attractive picture. You will get this. So if you look at that website, you'll say, wow, these guys are having a very good life. Okay, so that's what we want people to look at. We want a person to feel this is a better place to work in. More challenges are there. Okay, maybe that is something which will make a person engage in his or her work. Okay, so one of the things which you need to do is you need to give a proper scope of work. What you can do, what you cannot do. Again, if you are a manager, if you want a person, you have to define the scope of work very clearly. I want an engineer with 10 years experience. Will you get a good engineer? So what are the other things you may have to do? You may need to say he has to be a civil engineer. He has to have worked in, say, the hospital and such in, institutions, design. He should have worked in, for example, working in Assam, Chirapunji is not the same as working in Rajasthan. So this means you need to have relevant experience. Scope of work should be correctly defined. Then only you can do the scientific selection of workers. And end of the day, you will find that the required productivity is got. Okay. So, you can go through the cartoons when you are looking at it. So, this is another thing. Look at a workplace. This guy is working in the middle of the, you know, like with your air conditioner. And these people are chatting in the, you know, like in the water fountain. Here there's a guy sleeping. Somebody is celebrating. Okay. So, this sort of an environment, is it a nice one or a bad one? Bad? Good? Look guys, you are wanting to have that friendly environment, right? At the beginning of our lecture. There should be some moderation. Good. Okay. So today, for example, if you are an old style boss, maybe you'll be fuming like this guy. Maybe you'll be fuming like that guy. Okay. But in any case, you don't want this to happen. Profits going down is totally unacceptable for anybody. Today, if you look at the newspaper, the post mystery, Tata's performance in 5 have surpassed expectation, 8 it has slipped below the norm. Okay, so this means the top management's role has a very big influence. Okay, each of you should be a top manager. Okay, I want each of you to be your own boss, have your own business. Okay, at that time you need to choose the right people to get the work done. You need to set the right environment for the work to get done. Okay, so this is the biggest take home which I want to give you. Okay, so you need to understand whether you are going to take labor force as a asset or whether they are a liability. Are you going to complain, oh boy, they want holidays? Okay, whether you are looking at that or you are looking at people as, you know, assets. Again, I can always say, look, my boss, he comes and goes in a nice Audi car while I am coming on bicycle. I can complain. I can say he's having a much better life. So you see, when is this sort of an attitude going to change? When people are going to be engaged in their work. Okay. So you have to select the right applicants. Okay. You need to have the right testing process. Okay. Nowadays, if you look at the way people are called for is getting different. My brother-in-law who works in Google was called because of his continuous working with code. He was on the top of many of the leaderboards. Okay, so that got him the job. So the way you are selecting a applicant is now becoming different. Okay, I will continue the rest of the stuff in the next class, but today I want you to ask yourself this question. How are you going to project yourself if you are going to look for a job? Okay, so today the people are looking at your Facebook post, people are looking at your LinkedIn profile, people are looking at so many other things what you are doing. Okay, again, may I remind you that, you know, there is this option which I am giving you where you can start your own blog or something. I am willing to give you all the back-end infrastructure, I am willing to guide you, but you need to take that call. And again, you remember that, you know, one of your seniors, Aman Kushwaha, those of you who are in AC, you will know, he has his own business. He has his own business. He has his own design firm. He does his designs from here. He manages his business sitting here. Okay, construction business. Okay, how many of you dare to do that? Second year students, you still have 2.5 years to try to start your business. Okay, so it doesn't mean that, you know, you need to have a physical office literally. You can have a virtual office. You can have your uncle, your mother, somebody have a front office. You can hire people from here. Your father may have a business in your hometown. Please don't think of starting business in Delhi or any other place. If you're from a small hometown, if your place is a small place, you and your parents are doing some sort of business, you can do your designs from here. You can make the people work. Aman Kushwaha is now able to do malls and stuff like that. Just imagine if you at your final year are able to do a mall. You can start on Friday night from here, go to Bangalore or Chennai, fly. Saturday morning you are there, do your work on Saturday and Sunday, fly back to Vellore. You guys have it in you if you are willing to take that risk. Okay, you can do it. You can go to quite a lot of places, and if you are doing it as a business, all your expenses are waived off. If you are taking a flight ticket, you can reduce it from your tax liability. Okay, so guys, do think about this. We want you, at least I want you, to become a entrepreneur. You need to choose the right people, and that's what today's lecture was all about. Okay, do you think you can try to do it? Can you start your own business? Saying no is the easiest thing, but if you guys want to start a business, please do feel free to come and speak. Okay, we can try and help you out. So thank you very much.